we are going to test whether our attack is actually agnostic to the instruction embedded in the signals. So the main question here is that, is it only the matter of the rolling code and the counters, or also it depends on what is the instruction in the signals? So now we can see that this vehicle is open. And normally we were only talking about unlock signals. In the beginning, we were always focusing on the unlock signals. We wanted to capture unlock signals only. But for the sake of the attacker, it's actually easier to capture a lock signal and an unlock signal, because this is how we usually use the vehicle. So this is what we are going to test. So the vehicle is still unlocked. Now what I'm going to do is that I'm using the key fob. I will record the signal, a lock signal first, because that's the usual scenario when I just left the car in the parking lot. So then I go away. And then I actually like imitating the scenario when the victim comes back and unlocks the vehicle because he or she wants to drive the vehicle away. So this is what we're going to do. So now I capture a lock signal. That's a lock signal. You can see that the mirrors are folded and the vehicle is now unlocked. And then I capture an unlock signal. So it's two different signals. And I don't capture any more signals because we know that for this vehicle, we only need two signals. So now I'm going to replay this. But first, I have to save. So it's a lock and unlock. I just save it again. It takes quite some seconds. Okay, I have it. So now I just locked the vehicle, at least to get the rolling code system to be triggered at least once. And eventually I'm going to unlock it at the end. So we have basically a lock signal here and an unlock signal. I just remove the space here for the sake of time. So let's see what will happen. So now we replay the lock signal and the unlock signal. And you can see that the vehicle has been unlocked. So yeah, the mirrors again came off, the emergency lights were flashing, and we can access the vehicle. So basically to prove that this vehicle, and it actually applies for the Mazda vehicle as well, that it only requires two signals, or the Mazda vehicle requires three signals, but the whole attack is agnostic to the instruction in the signal. So it doesn't matter if it's a lock or an unlock signal, they are using the same rolling code. We just only have to replay those consecutive signals and it will work.